What up, everyone? I'm Rich Mays Lopez, and this is the release roundup for the weekend of October 28th. In this week's show, we're taking a look at sneaker releases that you need to know about from Jordan, Adidas, Nike, and Puma. And we have an inside look at what it's like to design the super limited miadidas UltraBOOST Xeno. Let's get into it. Before we get into this week's regularly scheduled releases, there are two release date updates that we need to talk about. The Wheat Nike Air Force One Low and the Doc Brown Nike Vandal High that were scheduled to drop earlier this month have both been moved to October 26th in the US. Retail price on the Vandal is $90 and retail on the AF One Low is $120. Both will be available on the Nike Sneakers app and at select Nike retailers. The Weeknd is dropping his second collection with Puma on Thursday, and it features deluxe denim clothing, accessories, and an olive Puma parallel. The military-inspired sneaker boot features Italian nubuck and leather, a zipper on the heel, XO branding, and Puma Ignite cushioning. Retail price is $220, release date is October 26th, and it will be available on Puma.com and at select Puma retailers. Nike and Supreme are linking up for the second time this season to drop an ACG-inspired collection that features trail running hats, trail running jackets, trail running pants, and four colors of the Nike Air Humara. The Supreme Humaras all feature Supreme branding, reflective accents, and two-tone colorways done in green black, blue black, pink black, and black on black. Release date is October 26th, exclusively on Supreme's online store at a retail price of $170. The Three Stripes is dropping a big winter collection on Friday that features premium, tech-forward, winterized versions of several new and classic styles. The collection features two Tubular Doom Adventures, two See You Later Adventure PKs, two NMD XR1 Adventure PKs, two Forum Adventure PKs, and two EQT Support Adventure PKs. All the pieces in the collection feature high-cut prime knit with tape seams, and the XR1 Adventure features Boost. The collection drops on October 27th, and it will be available on adidas.com and at select Adidas retailers. Nike is continuing the 30th anniversary of the Air Max 1 with a restock of the OG Blue colorway that first dropped back in March and sold out immediately. The sneaker is a 2017 upgraded version of the OG, and it features a mix of mesh, running suede, done in gray, blue, and white. Release date is October 27th at a retail price of $140, and it will be available on the Nike Sneakers app and at select Nike retailers. Nike's self-lacing, pressure-sensitive, and foot-sensing HyperAdapt 1.0 returns on Friday with the release of the Tinker Blue colorway. The colorway was handpicked by the sneaker's co-designer, the legendary Tinker Hatfield himself, and it features a mix of blue, black, and white. This is a very limited release, dropping on the Nike Sneakers app on October 27th at a retail price of $720. Nike is linking up with Ruby Rose to drop the Forces Female Pack on Friday, which features a Nike Air Force One Low and a Nike SF AF One. Both sneakers feature Rose's inspirational quotes and a port wine and sail colorway. The AF One Low features patent leather and premium leather, and the SF AF One features patent leather and defense mesh. Release date for both is October 27th, with the Air Force One priced at $100 and the SF AF One priced at $230. Both will be available on the Nike Sneakers app and at select Nike retailers. Steph Curry's Under Armour Curry 4 makes its official debut this week with the release of the white-black colorway. The sneaker is performance-tuned for Curry's game, and it features a knit internal sleeve, tape seams, UA speed plate, a cross-centric traction pattern, and a new foam cushioning system. Aesthetically, it features a mix of white and black, the SE logo on the midsole, the UA logo on the heel, and an icy outsole. Release date is October 27th, retail price is $130, and it will be available on underarmour.com and at select UA retailers. Adidas and Palace are linking up to drop a fall-winter collection that features several pieces of clothing and two colorways of the new Adidas Palace Pro 2. The Palace Pro 2 features a seamless and one-piece molded upper, Palace branding, and a translucent gum sole with a Three Stripes branding underneath. Release date for the collection is October 27th at Palace stores and at Palace online. LeBron James' newest signature sneaker makes its official retail debut this weekend with the release of the Ashes Nike LeBron 15. The black and gray colorway is inspired by LeBron's past, and it features a new finer material that Nike is calling Battle Knit, which was designed specifically for LeBron and his style of play, as well as a brand new combination of Air Max and Zoom Air cushioning. Release date is October 28th at a retail price of $185, and it will be available on the Nike Sneakers app, select Nike retailers, select Dick's Sporting Goods stores, and online at Dick's Sporting Goods. Jordan Brand is linking up with Aleali May to drop the Satin Shadows Air Jordan 1 High on Saturday. The collab is inspired by Aleali's LA upbringing and her love for house slippers and satin shorts. It features the Shadow Jordan 1 colorway of black, gray, and white with a hit of red on the tongue, and it is done in a mix of satin, corduroy, and chenille. Release day is October 28th at a retail price of $160, and it will be available on the Nike Sneakers app and at very select Jordan retailers. Last week, we hit up the Adidas flagship store here in Midtown New York City, and we got the exclusive opportunity to design a miadidas UltraBOOST Xeno. Here's what went down. What up, everyone? I'm Rich Mays Lopez, and this is the Release Roundup, and we are coming to you from the Adidas flagship location here in Midtown New York City, 46th Street and 5th Avenue. And today, we have the exclusive opportunity to design our own miadidas UltraBOOST. And for the first time, Adidas is offering two different options, and that includes Xeno cages and the Xeno heel counter and triple black boost, which means black boost midsoles. In addition to that, they are offering white primeknit and white boost and legend ink and white boost and black boost. We're about to head upstairs and link up with one of the design directors to design our own miadidas UltraBOOST. Let's check it out.
Rich, yeah. Hector, man, I'm the miadidas specialist here at Flagship 5th Avenue store.
Okay.
What we have here is the My UltraBOOST Xeno. For the first time, you're able to actually do a triple black variation of the UltraBOOST. This is a 3.0 that we're going to be using here.
Okay.
Your upper choices are going to be either a white upper, a black upper. You also have the Legend Ink upper as well.
Let me see a white upper.
White upper?
Yeah.
Sure. Got you here. Man, so that'll be your white upper. So since you pick white upper here, your cage could either be Xeno reflective or just classic white. We actually do have it on display.
Can we get one?
Yeah, sure. So this is going to be the classic flat white.
Okay. And the Xeno really more reflects like when it's flashed on, right? Like 3M. Like
if you have your phone right now and took a picture, you'd actually be able to see it reflect. There you go. Man. But also switch your tongue label.
Is this flat white? Oh,
that's
Xeno
gonna
white.
Be Xeno white, yeah.
Okay, let's go Xeno white.
If you didn't want that to necessarily be white and you want to change it around, you could also do it black Xeno, Legend Ink reflective, or black reflective. Flat white isn't an option, unfortunately.
Gotcha.
Yeah, but we could go that Xeno white and it matches everything. It kind of gives it that 1.0 kind of off-white look to it.
Yeah, I want to like recreate the joints that Kanye was rocking, like where he did the jump in, like it was all white.
All white ones.
Then with a black sole.
Once you switch your midsole white, your heel clip's gonna be white.
But how about if I go to outsole?
Your outsole.
And make that
we
black.
We can make that black, bam.
And then let me see the laces in white. Yeah, that's the one right there.
But we'll run through it again. So you have your upper is white.
Yep.
You have Xeno white on the heel clip, Xeno white. Your laces are white, second pair is black. Your tongue label is Xeno white.
Yep.
Your continental rubber sole at the bottom is going to be black. That's pretty much about it, Rich.
Yeah,
just gotta appreciate add it to the bag. There you go, dude. You're good to go.
Thank you,
man. No doubt, bro.
If you missed out on the My Adidas UltraBOOST Xeno release here in New York City, don't worry. There are rumors that you will be able to design a pair at select flagship locations around the world, and you might be able to design a pair on adidas.com as well. Stay tuned for more info on that. And now for the pick of the week presented by The Score at Dick's Sporting Goods. The Ashes Nike LeBron 15. As always, Nike and LeBron are changing the game. They've introduced two new technologies with BattleKnit and the combination of Air Max and Zoom Air. This will be a performance beast. You can cop a pair at select Dick's Sporting Goods and on dickssportinggoods.com. That's it for this week's Release Roundup. Hit us up in the comments to let us know if you're copying anything. Make sure to check out the release date section on SoulCollector.com for all the most important sneaker releases and subscribe to Soul Collector on YouTube. I'm Rich Mays Lopez. Best of luck this weekend.